Mother and your grandmother have both made me feel very welcome.
Well, in that case, I think the Sanders family inspection is over, and I have come to rescue you.
I don't really think he needs rescuing, do you, Gord?
No, sir, I don't think I do, but when a woman as beautiful as this comes into a room and says she wants to rescue me, I'm more than ready to be rescued.
Come on, cowboy. Bye, y'all.
Excuse us.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Y'all. Great heavens, he's begun to infect her speech.
Mother, you said that they had your blessing, too. You're an old fraud.
I resent that, Charles. I gave my blessing, and I meant it.
Then why don't you want him to be a member of the family business?
What in the world gave you that idea?
Mother, I was standing right here. I heard you. You tried to talk him out of my offer. Do you still have a problem with his background? Is the fact that he's half Mexican still disturb you all that much?
Now, that really does offend me, Charles. In spite of what you think, I like Cordero. Mm. If for no other reason than that he loves our Kate. He can be half Mexican or half Cocker Spaniel. As long as Kate makes him happy and he makes her happy, I want him to be happy too.
Then why not include him in the business instead of trying to keep him out of it?
It is called compassion.
Oh.
I don't want to force that young man into choosing between the work he loves and an obligation he might feel just because he's marrying Kate.
Am I hearing you correctly? Are you actually saying that you will permit Kate as well as Cordero to decide on their own future?
Is there any doubt? Excuse me, Charles.
Mother, I haven't finished talking to you yet.
Darling, I have a million things to do before the wedding. Save your questions for another day.
Tina, I really am strong enough to hold him now. Tina? Oh, of course. Of course. I miss you, baby. Oh, he's beautiful, just like you said.
Oh, he sure loves being held in your arms.
Oh, I think he just likes being held, no matter who's doing the holding.
No. He knows who his mother is. Now he knows that.
If you're trying to talk me out of what I have to do, don't bother.
I'm trying to tell you how lucky you really are. Gabriel, when I held this baby in my arms, I didn't want to give him back. And now that you have him in your arms...
I understand you. So try and understand me.
I can't understand how you could give up a baby like this who loves you and needs you so much.
You fight for him as if he were your very own.
No. No, he's not mine.
But he did bring us together, just as his father did. You know you have a father? Yes, you do. My sweet little one, you do. And his name is Max Holden. There, I said it. That's the last time you'll ever hear your father's name from me.
I can't talk you out of it, huh?
My family will take him away. Or I'll find the most loving home I can for him. Those are my choices, Tina.
Well, I guess I've done all I can here, then. So I'll get some rest, and then I'll go back home to Landview. And, you know, I can't wait to see everybody's face when they see I'm alive. I'm sure it's going to be quite a surprise to all of them.
Promotion to detective second grade, 2 sergeants, 1 lieutenant, and your promotion to captain. You want to go first or last?
Hey, if it's okay, I'd like to go last to give me some more time to get my speech together.
You got it.
Thanks.
Rafe, congratulations.
Thanks, Herb.
sir.
Herb, I wonder if I have a word with the new captain here.
Yeah, be my guest.
Petey, I hardly recognize you. You look like a train conductor.
And you have a nice day, too, eh, sir?
Listen, Nathan, why don't you bury the hatchet with Pete? He's a good man.
Rafe, you have a right to your own opinion. I don't want to talk about that man. I want to remind you, when they pin those bars on you, you're in that yourself. I had nothing to do with your promotion.
Yeah, I know. I checked. And if you had pulled strings like you did the last time, contributing to the Widows and Orphans Fund to get me reinstated.
Rafe, I make a contribution every year. I'm going to continue to do so, especially now that you've made captain.
Well, no funny stuff, Ace, okay?
Rafe!
Hey, Andy.
Hey.
We interrupt one
without moment. An invitation.
Pam, thank God. I've been trying to track you down all day.
Steve.
Listen, a couple of our guests checked out this morning without paying their bill. Now, they claim they got sick because of the chlorine in the pool.
Apparently, they did. It appears that the chlorine level was way above safety.
Yeah, I know. Harold showed me the results of the test, but he swears that none of our men screwed up.
Steve, somebody made a mistake.
Well, what I'm saying is maybe it wasn't a mistake. Now, maybe somebody is playing games with us and is trying to cause trouble. I'm not naming any names, and I don't know this to be true for a fact, but it seems like a pretty good bet to me.
Well, one name just popped into my mind.
I need to do it again. Okay. Are you sure you don't want to find me, Linda King?
No, I just do this for the exercise.
Then it must be a man.
Yes, then it's a long, sad story, and it's really not worth telling.
My purse. Oh.
Yeah, it's on the couch.
Thank you. I would lose my head if it wasn't attached.
You want to hear these budget figures on the ad campaign?
Was there a problem?
No, we'll get by them.
You seem upset.
Yeah. I've been looking at these designs by Gabrielle.
Yeah, they're sensational.
Yeah, but they make me feel guilty as hell. I mean, I've done some pretty crummy things in my life, but using her sketches without her permission ranks right up there at the top.
Max, this was all my fault. I shouldn't have signed my name to them, but, well, the bar from Lonigan's was after me, and I just didn't know how to get out of it.
Yeah. We got to make it right. We got to tell Gabrielle. Only problem is finding her.
You haven't heard from her?
No. Last time I talked to her grandmother, she wouldn't give me any information at all. Delilah, you know what? If you call her, she might open up. You tell her you need to talk to her about her designs and everything. Yeah, I'll make the call.
Listen, Max, can we wait and do this tomorrow, please? I mean, this is Rafe's big day, and he's counting on me. He's been so patient and understanding with all of my new business. I can't disappoint him today.
Yeah, sure, I understand.
Yes.
Oh,
you're serious.
Oh,
it's
a beautiful day. It's
going to
be so
big.
And Daddy's
going to
wonder how come we're not there. Are you ready,
Max?
Yes, I am.
Well,
so.
I'm glad to hear that. It's about
coming.
Are you going to join us?
Oh, you go ahead. I'll meet you later.
Okay. Let's go, sweet
potatoes.
Yes.
Max, I really feel
awful. Don't. Come on. Rafe's your number one priority today. You take care of business tomorrow. I'll finish up here. I'll meet you back at the ceremony.
Thanks, Max. Okay, here we go.
We have Buenos Aires, Argentina.
I'm sorry, sir. Your name's not on the list?
Yeah, well, I think it'll be all right, son.
I have my instructions. I'm sorry, sir.
Uh-huh. Well...
Excuse me. Ed! Oh, my word, Ed Hall. What a wonderful surprise.
Oh, it's so good to see you.
So good to see you.
Well, where's the cowboy? Huh?
Oh, Clint had to go to Arizona to his ranch to take care of something.
Listen, Rafe told me about your surgery. Now, how are you feeling?
I'm getting stronger every single day.
Oh, that's terrific.
Come on, let's go inside and talk.
Well, listen, it seems I don't have an invitation, and my name is not down there anywhere, so I'll just watch through the door.
Oh, don't be ridiculous. I have an invitation that says admit, too. You'll be my guest. Don't you know who this is? This is Ed Hall, former captain of the Landview Police Department. Would you like me to get the police commissioner to vouch for it?
Oh, no, ma'am. That won't be necessary. I'm sorry, Captain.
No problem, son. No problem at all. It's all right. Thank you.
Now, why on earth didn't you tell him who you were?
Well, those days of pulling rank are over, Vicky.
You make it sound like you've retired.
Well, I haven't.
Why?
Why, Paul? It seemed like a good move.
I can't believe that your superiors agreed with that.
Yeah, well...
How long have you been in town?
Just about, an hour. Just came in from the airport.
How's Sadie?
Sadie is fine. She's just fine. Sends her love to everybody.
Oh, that's great. Yeah. And how's Carla?
Carla is fine, too. We, we tried to get it back together, but it didn't work out.
Oh, I'm sorry.
No. We tried. We really tried, but I guess it wasn't just meant to be. That's all. So how are the kids?
Oh, they're wonderful. They are. Oh, you know we had a girl.
Yes. Rafe told me. Jessica is beautiful, I hear.
She sure is. Are you going to be around long enough to come and have dinner? I want to show the children off, and I want to catch up with you.
Well, I'll be here for a couple of days.
Can you make it for dinner tomorrow night at Lamfair? Could you?
Well, thanks. I'd love to.
Oh, that's wonderful.
Yes.
Come on, let's go say hi to Rafe. He's going to be so excited that you're here.
Wait a minute. Maybe you just go say something to him. I'll just find a place over here where I won't be noticed, okay?
You can't do that.
Well, certainly I can do that. Now, I'll see him later. It'll be okay. I'll just go right ahead.
Are you sure?
I'm sure. I'm definitely sure. I think Rafe should, be in the spotlight alone, all right?
All right. Oh, welcome home.
Oh, thank you.
There you are.
Vicky.
Congratulations. Oh, I'm so proud of you.
Yeah, well, I hope you feel the same after my speech. I can't seem to remember anything of what I wanted to say.
Oh, come on. Relax, take a deep breath. You will be brilliant.
I hope so.
Now, Clint was very sorry he could not be here today, and so were the children. But they picked out something for you.
Oh, that was sweet of them. Oh, this is beautiful.
Well, I'll tell you, that's real smart looking. I would get one of those for myself.
It is an official tie pin, Asa. You cannot have one unless you are a member of the police department. Don't sulk. I'll buy you a nice one, too.
I am not sulking. I'm just looking for Pamela. She should be here by now. Now, what the devil can be keeping her?
You know, all those tricks Asa pulled when we started the renovations of this hotel, he never, ever quits. But he's just been planning all kinds of sabotage. Believe me, I know him. I know how he operates, especially when he doesn't get his way.
Pam, Ace is capable of causing a lot of trouble, pulling every trick in the book, for that matter, but I...
No. He wrote the book. I'm sure he's the one that's behind it.
Pam, I don't think that it's very smart of us to start accusing Ace without any proof. Now, we could be wrong.
What if we are right?
Then it's all the more reason to keep quiet about it. We'll never get any evidence on him if his guard is up.
Oh, come on, Steve. I do not need evidence. I just have to look at dirt. I have to look him in those beady little eyes just once, and I will know whether he's behind this or not. Excuse me.
After this wedding, I am going to need a vacation. I hope you can give me a few days off.
Well, we'll see.
Shall we?
But it is an exciting time, huh?
Oh, boy, it certainly is. And Kate is positively glowing. I am so happy for her.
Will they be married in a church?
In a chapel, actually. Huh. It's going to be a Catholic and Jewish ceremony. Elizabeth is trying to get an Episcopal priest thrown in, but I think she's fighting a losing battle.
So, you'll be spending a lot of time with the family, huh?
Oh, yes, but I won't neglect my work here.
Well, actually, I have an assignment for you that will fit right in with your wedding activities.
What's that?
Well, I want you to find out as much about Elizabeth as you can for me.
Oh, and if you want to make a formal bid to Sanders Chemical for the services of Dinah women, no problem. I can set up a meeting for you. Of course, Elizabeth will be busy till after the wedding, but that's on the 8th.
No. Signing on Sanders Chemicals, I'll think about that in the future. But right now, my main concern is Elizabeth. I want to find out as much about her as I can.
I don't know if I like the sound of that, Lee.
Yeah, well, you don't have to like it. You just have to do it.
I can't do it, Lee. The Sanders treat me like family. Judith is almost like a mother to me.
You know, from what I hear, Judith and Elizabeth can't stand each other, so you can probably get most of your information from Judith.
Lee, I have been willing to do everything you've asked me to do, but this...
Cindy, I am not asking you. I am telling you.
But you have no right to.
Look, if you work for my company, I have a right to your time, your energy, and your resources. And you know as well as I do that no other company will touch you.
You know, this is beginning to sound like blackmail.
Look, I don't care what it sounds like. I have some advice for you. If you care about your future, you will think twice about turning down this assignment. Now, unless your loyalty and your friendship to Kate are worth the price, then I suggest that you follow my orders without questioning them from now on.
You really should wear this uniform more often.
Tell that to Asa. He thinks I should be collecting tickets on a train.
Well, that's because you're younger and prettier than he is.
I knew that was another reason I like having you around. I'm glad you're here.
Well, I'm sorry I'm late.
Oh, hey, Pam.
Congratulations. Congratulations. You must be so excited.
Yeah, it's sort of like the World Series for me, something I've been dreaming about for a long time.
Well, I certainly couldn't have picked a better man.
Thanks.
Listen, is Delilah here yet? I mean, we're getting a little behind schedule.
Well, she should be here soon.
Well, she'll probably walk in a minute. You know, the traffic out there is really terrible.
Looking at me for? We're doing everything we can about the traffic congestion. Now, listen, time's wasting. We got to get on the ball here.
5 more minutes, okay?
Okay, 5 minutes. Thanks.
All right, I guess I'm going to find a seat. I'll be listening to your speeches very carefully.
Okay. You call me any time, Inspector. I'm happy to be of service.
Very good.
Well, just keeping up your contacts in case you get into trouble.
Pamela, I was worried about you.
Oh, really? Why?
Well, I mean, running the hotel now, I thought you'd miss the ceremony. You look gorgeous. I mean, work sure agrees with you.
Well, it must be the exercise I've been getting. You know, I decided to take a swim every single morning in the pool at the hotel.
When did you start that?
I mean, don't you think that's a terrific idea?
Well, yeah, I do, but I wish I'd have known about it. You could come out and swim in my pool.
Well, no, then I have to drive all the way out there and drive all the way back. This way, just to take the elevator, go down right there. Why, do you have something against hotel pools?
Oh, no, but I thought you'd be more comfortable in the pool all by yourself. Unless, of course, you invited me.
Why, Asa, you're invited to come over to the hotel anytime you want.
You be careful, Pam. Vicky, you look beautiful.
Asa, you are so good for my ego. Thank you. Herb was just telling me about his new suite over at the inn. Seems Pamela has quite an instinct for running a hotel.
Well, I'll tell you, she better start hiring managers with experience. There's a lot more to running a hotel than putting pieces of candy on pillows.
And my feeling is she's learning very quickly.
Mm-hmm. I think we should be seated.
Yes, we probably should. Herb, why don't you sit with us?
With pleasure.
You're welcome.
Okay.
You know cops, right? They like action.
All right, Pete, you better get started. Maybe Delilah will be here in time for my speech, you know?
Okay.
Okay, I'm sorry. Excuse us.
Hey.
Excuse us. I am so sorry that we're late.
Just in time. Hey, pumpkin. You look terrific.
Are you okay? Are you nervous or anything?
Now that you're here, I'm fine. I'll wave to you, okay?
Come on. Okay. Sit down.
Oh, thanks,
Martin.
Okay.
Could we all take our seats, please? Ladies and gentlemen, I take tremendous pride in being able to participate in this ceremony. See, we take pride in every member of the Lambeauta Police Department. They are individuals who are known for their courage, their character, and their dedication to duty. But we take a very special pride in those men and women who have distinguished themselves as leaders of this very elite fraternity. So we're here today to
to reward those achievements with promotions. Most of them are probably long overdue. You know, I have to tell you something. I got a chance to look over the sergeant's exam. I'm glad I didn't have to take it. I never would have been commissioner.
Okay, I'm going to chalk up and try this again. Thanks, Deb. All right. Got it?
Yep.
I got you. Keep your head up. Good. Okay, let me try the hip circle. Then we can put this all together. Okay, you ready?
Yep.
Head. Head up.
Oh, there you go.
Great.
Got it.
All together. Throw in my giant. I'm there. Yeah, I think so.
Hi, Kath. Are you going to Rafe's ceremony?
No. Kathy, maybe you should go along. All those handsome men in uniform?
Well, I think I'll give up on cops and detectives for a while.
Cheryl Peterson, telephone call for Miss Cheryl Peterson.
That's the call I've been expecting. Excuse me.
You and Cheryl are getting to be friends, huh?
Yeah, we work out together sometimes.
Sure. Well, she seems like a nice girl. Come on, Cassie, this is a little ridiculous, isn't it?
What?
Well, we're two grown adults. You'd think we could have a conversation.
I'm not good at small talk, John.
Oh, come on, you're always able to talk about anything.
I just can't with you right now. It's just not easy for me.
You won't even try? Come on, we're going to be running into each other all over Landview. What do you want me to do, cross the street in order to avoid you? Or if you're in a restaurant, you want me to go running out? Or maybe you enjoy keeping me in the deep freeze. Are you really that angry?
It's not anger, John. Talking to you is just too painful for me.
You okay?
Steve.
I couldn't help seeing you sitting here with Lee. You seem to be having it out. What happened?
I really don't want to discuss it, okay?
Okay. I thought maybe you could use a sounding board, that's all.
Just forget it.
Well, okay, Cindy, don't bite my head off. I'm just asking as a friend.
Well, don't ask, okay? It is between Lee and me.
Okay. You don't want to talk about the argument. We'll talk about something else. The wedding. That's a safe topic, right?
I can't go to the wedding with you, Steve.
But Cindy, we made a date.
I changed my mind.
Wait, hold it, Cindy. I don't know what you're so upset about, but don't take it out on me, all right? Let's just start this all over from the top. Just pretend that I just walked up and said hello.
I have to go.
What?
Steve. Got to see you about the pool.
Yeah, what is it?
I did some checking around the alley behind the pool. Came up with this. It's empty, too.
Well, this isn't the brand we use. Which means that that contamination must have been deliberate.
That's the way I figure it.
Oh, man, we got trouble. Let's go.
You don't want to be late.
Cassie, we can't leave things this way. I can't pretend like I just don't know you. Come on, we've been through a lot together. We can get through this.
What am I supposed to do? Just pretend I don't have feelings for you? Act like I haven't been hurt?
We've all been hurt. You, me, Dorian. Things got out of control and blew up in our faces, but that's why we have to try and get through this.
I just can't turn my feelings off. I'm not good at that.
Why can't we at least be friends?
I don't want to be a friend.
How about my employee?
You want me to work for you?
Yeah. Try and normalize things. The job's yours if you want it.
And we are supposed to just pick up and act like nothing's happened.
Well, it's better than what we're doing to each other here. Besides, you're the only one that knows where everything's filed.
John, how can you make jokes about this right now?
I'm sorry, Cassie. I'm too old to cry. But think about it. It's a way to get back on track. Hey, you liked your job and you were good at it.
You really expect for both of us to be in an office all day and keep playing the charade?
Yeah. Seemed like a good idea. Accept things the way they are. Move on. Maybe not. Maybe I don't really know what I think anymore.
Yeah. Well, you can find someone else to hire, okay?
excuse me. I don't want to be late for the reception.
Senora Imaz, this is Max Holden. I've been trying to reach you for the last hour.
I was in church.
Well, how are you?
I'm well.
And how is Gabrielle?
She's not here, Max.
Senora, it is very important that I find Gabrielle. It's about her future.
Her future? What are you talking about?
Well, I know what kind of shape she's in, and I know how ashamed she's feeling, but it's not her fault.
You know her shame?
Well, of course. I mean, she's not responsible for her father's crimes.
I know how he's disgraced her, and I think I might be able to help her through it.
You know those sketches of hers that you sold to me? I can get a lot of money for her. And then she can live wherever she wants and do whatever she wants. She doesn't have to worry about anything, but I need to talk to her about it.
Max, fashion sketches are the least of Gabrielle's worries right now.
What do you mean?
The disgrace her father brought to the family name, of course.
Senora Naz, is Gabrielle in any kind of trouble? If she is, just let me know so I can help.
She doesn't want your help. And it's too late now, Max, too late. She's no concern of yours, not anymore. And please, don't bother me anymore.
The doctor said I could take Anacin 3 for my headache.
And my door is always open to you. So if you have a complaint or an idea, let me know about it. We're a team. And the day we cease to cooperate with each other is the day we cease to be effective. Okay. I'm grateful to Captain Ed Hall, who held this job for a lot of years and set a lot of standards that I'll try to maintain. I'm also grateful for the support of my fellow officers, especially Andy Moore. I'll do my best to justify your faith in me. And last but not least, I'd like to thank my wife, Delilah. We know our jobs are toughest on our wives and our families. So when your wife tells you to go for it, knowing the sacrifice that you'll have to make, you have to know that you're one hell of a lucky man. Thank you.
Captain, if you meant what you said about your open door policy.
Yeah, well, the door isn't open till tomorrow.
Nice going, guy. Hey, anytime you need any help, I'll be there to help you.
I know that, Andy. Excuse me a second, folks.
Just a second.
Call your own shots, Rafe. Don't you let the brass of you dance to their tune. You are your own man.
Don't worry about a thing, Asa. I spoke to the commissioner. He's going to give me his full support.
Sam, you haven't taken your eyes off Asa since you got here. What's up?
Something just too awful to contemplate.
Really? Nothing that man says or does would surprise me.
Yeah, that's what I thought once. But now, boy, even I'm amazed.
The best officer and most respected gentleman you know is sitting right over there. Let's go say hello to him.
He's gone! Oh, no.
Vicky, what?
Where did he live?
I saw Ed take off just after my speech.
But he came such a long way to see you get your captain's bars. Where would he leave?
He's got this thing about stepping into my limelight. I tried to talk him out of it, but, you know. Look, I better get back to Delilah, okay?
Yeah, sure, go ahead.
Three of you resolved anything?
That's a topic I'd rather not discuss, Herb.
Gather the answer is no. You really screwed it up, John.
Well, that's my business.
Oh, no. Doreen's my ex-wife, and Cassie is my
daughter, I have a right to be concerned about their welfare, and from what I know of the situation, he could have stopped it.
You don't know the whole story, Herb.
What else is there to know? Cassie fell for you. You let her on. Dorian felt betrayed, turned on Cassie, and you turned your back on both of them.
Well, I didn't plan on having it happen that way, Herb, and if I had to do it over again, it wouldn't. And for your information, it was Dorian that forced things out of control. If her damn pride hadn't gotten in the way, nobody would have gotten hurt.
Dorian's not the one I'm worried about. I feel sorry for her. Cassie's really been hurt by this. She thinks because she's been married that she's all grown up, but she's not.
I know this is tearing her apart, and I wish I could do something about her, but I can't order my feelings around any more than Cassie can.
You do care about her, don't you?
You're damn right I care about her. And if it would work out, I would tell her exactly how I feel. But that's not fair to Cassie.
What are you going to do?
I don't know. I asked her to come back to work for me, try to normalize things. She said she couldn't do it. So maybe I'll just bury my head in the sand. If that doesn't work, take an assignment in China.
Hey, Max. You got a hot date?
No, I'm going to the ceremony for Rafe.
Well, can't hurt keeping friendly with the police, huh?
A respectable businessman now. I'm in business with the captain's wife. Gotta be so careful. I feel like a cat in the middle of a rocking chair. How you doing?
Striking out on all fronts.
Well, how's the friendship with Cindy London coming?
She's not being too friendly lately. She just told me to forget our date to Kate's wedding. Said it was all a big mistake.
What do you think? We Holden brothers are losing our touch or something?
I don't know. I can't figure these women out.
Well, tell you what. Why don't you come to the reception with me? Maybe there'll be a nice policewoman there to blow you away.
Well, thanks, but I got a few problems to solve myself. You didn't hear about this pool incident, huh?
I heard a few guests mention it.
Yeah, it was deliberate.
Really? Who?
I don't know. Some hotel employee with an axe to grind, maybe. I got my maintenance crew keeping a close eye on things, and I'm double-checking everything myself. Hopefully, whoever it is has got their revenge, and this will be the end of it.
Yeah, I hope so. Hey, listen, if you need any help, just let me know, okay?
All right.
We'll see you.
Oh, come on, you know him. He knew that it was Ray's day. He didn't want anybody making a fuss over him. I'm sure he's so proud of you. Oh.
Now, just make sure he comes to the reception, okay?
I'll get him there. I'll see you later,
okay.
Honey.
Sweetheart.
Okay.
Okay. Oh, here, come
okay.
Here.
Oh, yes.
You go to Mommy 1 minute.
Oh, okay.
Come
stand here.
Hello,
nice to see
you.
Daddy.
Hello.
Thank you.
How are you holding up?
Oh, honey, I'm fine, thank you. It is wonderful to be out and among friends. I do wish Clint were here, though. I think he would be very, very pleased for Rafe.
Ah, well, how much longer is he going to stay in Arizona?
Until he resolves the crisis that he's having out there.
Oh. Well, sometimes it's good for couples to get a little distance. Sometimes that little distance makes them get closer and closer.
I hope you're right. What am I saying? You're always right.
Oh, I'm sorry. Excuse me.
Well, hello, Max.
Hello there.
Do you know Wanda Warlick, Max Holden?
Best breakfast on East Coast?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. What about the lunches? And what about the dinners?
All right.
Okay. Excuse me, please. I want to help Delilah with them.
Right. Well, I must say it's very nice to see you again.
It's nice to see you. Oh,
thank you.
If there's something I've been meaning to give to you.
Pictures?
Gina.
Were they taken in Argentina?
Yeah, they're nothing professional or anything. We just took some of his records at the ranch, you know, so we could compare later on when we change things around.
Well, I'll give them back to you.
No, I had these prints made up for you. For yours to keep.
That's very, very kind of you. Would you mind terribly if I looked at them later?
No. It took me a long time before I could look at them without breaking up. Now I just focus on the happiness in Tina's life. You know, her love of life, and now it feels nice.
Very, very kind of you to do this. It means a great deal to me. Thank you.
Excuse me.
Here.
I thought you were going to be glued to that traffic cop the whole time.
Will you please lay off Pete Asa?
You're right. He is not worth the time or effort. What I can't understand is how come he has not bored you to death by now.
I don't have very much time for him these days. I seem to be working very hard on the end.
Now that is the best news I've heard all day.
You know, the hotel is 80% booked. Now that is good news.
That is wonderful. You're going to turn a profit soon.
Are you really pleased?
Of course I am. Want that hotel to be gold to you. You've earned it.
It wasn't too long ago you were trying to bankrupt me.
Now that, Pam, is a terrible remark.
Yes, but it's a very true remark, and I managed to finish those renovations in spite of all the obstacles you put in front of me. Now, why can't you just accept defeat with a little bit of grace? And get onto some other things.
Pamela, you and I will never accept defeat. Now that you can stand on your own two feet, I'm responsible for that. I'm through with that. I mean, you've got true grit. Pleases me no end.
Asa Buchanan, if you really mean that, I am so deeply pleased. But believe me, if you are playing games with me, you better be very careful, because I'm not going to stand for it.
What was that powwow with Asa?
I was just putting him on notice.
You think he's up to his old tricks?
Yeah.
Anything you want me to help you with?
No. I'm going to handle this, and I want to handle it my own way. Come on.
Everything's going ahead as planned? No, I don't foresee any difficulties at all.
Oh, okay, you guys, we're going to get this right tonight.
Ooh. Hi, Cass. How's it going?
I am pooped. I would like to hit the pool, but...
Well, go ahead. It's open.
Well, we heard a rumor there was a problem.
No, it's solved.
Oh, do you think it was some kind of sick joke or what?
Well, I'm not taking any chances. I put a 24-hour guard on that pool starting now.
Good.
And I think I'm going to close up all these facilities a little early today.
Yeah.
Cassie, you work for a private eye. You got any ideas?
I don't work for John anymore.
Well, since when?
Since last week. But I'll tell you, I do have an idea. If someone is out to cause trouble, I doubt they'll strike the same place twice.
Yeah, that's what I figured, too. That's why I thought I'd close up everything a little early.
Steve, maybe you should talk to Pam about hiring some extra protection.
Yeah, I think I'll do that.
Okay, I'm going to hit the showers. Don't forget about that talk with Pam, though.
I won't. Excuse me, I'm going to lock up a little early today.
Congratulations.
Thanks, Ed.
Thanks for the bars. I'll wear them with pride.
Ah, well, they belong on a uniform. Looked in the back of the drawer, sent them to the commissioner so he could pin them on you.
Well, if you ever decide to come out of retirement, you can have them back.
Oh, no, no, no. Once retired, always retired.
Once a cop, always a cop.
Maybe. Maybe in my heart. But my body really likes retirement.
Oh, no, 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 no. You sit over there. It's nice to see an old pro in the chair.
When I made captain, that chair was wood. None of that fancy upholstered stuff for us.
Well, it was Delilah's idea. She sent it over as a gift.
Ah, I saw her. Beautiful as ever.
Thanks, Ed. Why'd you take off without saying hello to her?
Oh, I'll see her before I leave.
So how you been?
Oh, didn't you read any of the cards I sent you?
Yeah, they didn't tell me much.
Well, I've been busy.
Mm-hmm. Doing what?
Taking it easy.
You miss the action?
No, are you kidding me? All I ever thought about for years was doing nothing. No more paperwork and triplicate. No more brass to polish. No more rookies to worry about.
You do miss it.
Yeah, sometimes. Especially after I see all the guys at the ceremonies, you know. I really love those ceremonies.
Brought back your own induction, huh?
Yeah, as a rookie. Then there was your rookie year. You've come a long way, son.
I hope I don't blow it.
You won't. Can you learn anything from me?
A hell of a lot.
No, I'm sure.
I'm going to need everything you taught me to do this job.
Well, you just stay cool. You're a good cop. You'll be fine. Of course, the brass doesn't always know what they're doing all the time. They have a pretty good record of picking captains, though. If I ever decide to go back on the force, it's kind of nice to know I'll have a friend in high places.
Oh, you didn't make it for the ceremony,
I'm
did
sorry,
you?
Sorry, no. Where's Ray?
Well, he'll be back in a minute. He's talking with an old friend. What took you so long?
He's trying to reach Mrs. Imaz.
Max, I thought we were going to wait and call her tomorrow.
Yeah, I changed my mind, all right? And I don't know. I think something's wrong with Gabrielle. I think she may be in trouble. Her grandmother tried to make me think everything was all right, but she was scared to death for Gabrielle.
What kind of trouble could she be in?
Well, you remember that drug kingpin down in Buenos Aires connected with Jamie?
The one that was growing the cocoa leaves on your ranch.
Yeah, that's Gabrielle's father. She may be in hiding because some of his cohorts are trying to seek revenge.
What about the police? Can't they protect her?
Not if they want her dead. There's nothing they can do. That's where I was thinking maybe I should go down there and try to find her.
No, Max, I think that's getting a little too carried away.
Delilah, you don't know these people like I do. They nearly destroyed me, and they responsible for Tina's death.
Listen, why don't we talk to Rafe about all this? He can get in touch with the police in Argentina, and they can find Gabrielle. Don't you think that's a better idea than running out to Buenos Aires with just your instincts to go on?
Very nice.
Yeah. I really thought I wasn't going to look at them until I got home, and then suddenly I found I couldn't resist looking at them. Oh, I wish I could get back one day with Tina, just one day, to make up for all the harsh things I said to her and all the times I turned my back on her.
Sometimes she deserved that, Becky.
I know she wasn't an angel. Neither was I. I keep thinking if only I'd shown her a little bit more love, a little bit more understanding, maybe I could have made her see the pain that she was causing. Anyway, it's too late to make amends. It's too late for me to tell her that I loved her.
Good morning. Excuse me, sir. I'm sorry. I guess I have the wrong room.
Oh?
Yeah, you see, I was looking for my fiancé, and he never dresses like that, especially not at 8 in the morning.
Well, I think it is 5 minutes to 8, to be precise.
Are you telling me what is going on?
Well, what's the matter? Don't you like it?
Yes, I like it. You look absolutely ravishing.
Oh, well,
but why?
Thank you. Well, after that discussion I had with your father yesterday, I didn't want to tell you about this till I made a decision myself, and I have come to a decision, Kate. I hope that this is what the well-dressed executive over at Sanders Chemicals is wearing this year.
It was.
Where are you going?
I have a breakfast meeting in the restaurant. And you?
I'm going to work out. Trying to get back into a routine.
Yes, exercise is so important. There's your elevator. Goodbye.
Mom, wait.
Cassie, I'm going to be late.
I would just like to maybe set up an appointment with you. We could have lunch today, tomorrow.
I'm booked solidly. For months.
So you won't give an inch, will you?
I already gave you a few inches too many already.
Fine. Keep the wall up. I'll just work out my frustration on the uneven parallel bars. Why even try to be constructive with you anymore?
Hey, Cassie, good morning.
Well, it was.
Yeah. Hey, Steve.
Oh.
I'll say good morning, but it doesn't seem to be a very popular thing to say today.
Oh, I'm sorry.
You got a minute?
Yeah, what is it?
Yeah, I'll tell you, I'm taking off for Buenos Aires this evening.
What?
No, it's not what you're thinking. Okay, it's Gabrielle. I think she may be in trouble. I want to help her.
What kind of trouble?
Tell you the truth, I'm not sure.